हेलो क्लास 10th, वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर 1 द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट. टुडेज टॉपिक इज एंटी डिफेक्शन लॉ. वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडेज टॉपिक इज मेंबर ऑफ अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी, इंडिपेंडेंट मेंबर्स, नॉमिनेटेड मेंबर्स, मर्जर ऑफ पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज, स्पेशल प्रोविजन फॉर स्पीकर, डेप्यूटी स्पीकर, Disqualification of the presiding officer, empowered to make rules, article 105. Now let's discuss some keywords. Number 1, nomination, it means selection. Number 2, sever, it means cut off. Number 3, incurring, it means sustaining. Number 4, willful, it means intentional. Number 5, contravention, it means violation. Next, abstains, it means not vote. Last word is defection. It means disloyalty. Anti-defection law. The 10th schedule of the constitution, popularly known as the anti-defection law, introduced by the constitution, 52nd amendment act 1985 as amended by the constitution, 91st amendment act 2003 lays down the conditions regarding disqualification on ground of defection. The main provisions of the 10th schedule are summarized below. The anti-defection law in India, also known as the 10th schedule to the Indian constitution, was enacted to address the perceived problem of instability caused by the democratically elected legislators in India's federal system of government shifting commitments from the parties they supported at the time of election or disobeying their party's decision at critical times. The 10th schedule was inserted in the constitution in 1985 by 52nd Amendment Act as amended by the constitution 91st Amendment Act in 2003. An elected member of parliament or a state legislature who has been elected as a candidate set up by a political party and a nominated member of a parliament or a state legislature who is a member of political party at the time he takes his seat would be disqualified on the ground of defection if he voluntarily gives up his membership of such political party or votes or abstains from voting in the House contrary to any direction of such party. The 10th schedule includes the following provisions with regard to the disqualification of MPs and MLAs on the ground of defection. If an elected member give up his membership of a political party voluntarily, or if he votes or formally declined to vote in the House contrary to any direction issued by the political party. An independent member of a parliament or a state legislature will also be disqualified if he joins any political party after his election. If a member has been elected as independent, he or she would be disqualified if he joined a political party. A nominated member of parliament or a state legislature who is not a member of a political party at the time of his nomination means election and who has not become a member of any political party before the expiry of 6 months from the date on which he takes his seat shall be disqualified if he joins any political party after the expiry of the said period of 6 months. If any nominated member who is not a member of political party at the time of his nomination and also has not become a member of any political party before the expiry of 6 months from the date on which he takes his seat shall be disqualified if he joins any party after the end of 6 months. Provisions have been made with respect to merger. Merger means union of political parties. No disqualification would be incurred. Incurred means sustained. When a legislature party decides to merge with another party and such decision is supported by not less than 2/3 of its members. There are some exceptions also under the anti-defection law. In the situation where 2/3 of the legislators of the political parties decide to merge into another party, neither the members who decide to merge nor the ones who stay with the original party will face disqualification. Special provisions has been made to enable a person who has been elected to the office of the Speaker or the Deputy Speaker of the House of People or of the Legislative Assembly of a State or to the office of the Deputy Chairman of the Council of States or the Chairman or the Deputy Chairman of Legislative Council of a State to sever means cut off his connection with his political party without incurring means sustaining disqualification. Any person elects as a chairman, speaker, deputy speaker can resign from his party and rejoin the party if he resigns that post. The question as to whether a member of a house or parliament or state legislature has become subject to the disqualification will be determined by the presiding officer of the house, where the question is with reference to the presiding officer himself, it will be decided by a member of the house elected by the house on that behalf. Any question regarding disqualification of a member of a house of parliament or state legislature arising out of defection is to be decided by presiding officer of the house. And if the question is with reference to the presiding officer himself, then it will be decided by the member of the house elected by the house on that behalf. The chairman or the speaker of a house has been empowered means allowed, to make rules for giving effect to the provisions of the 10th schedule. The rules shall be laid before the house and shall be subject to modifications. Modification means changes. Disapproval means criticized by the house. The rules made by the chairman or the speaker of a house shall be laid as soon as may be after they are made before the house for a total period of 30 days, which may be comprised in one session or in two or more successive sessions, and shall take effect upon the expiry the set period of 30 days unless they are sooner approved with or without modifications or disapproved by the House. Without prejudice to the provision of Article 105 or as the case may be Article 194 or any other power they may have under the Constitution, the Chairman or the Speaker of a House has been empowered to direct that any willful means intentional, contravention means violation by any person of the rules made under the paragraph 8 of the 10th schedule may be dealt with means share out within the same manner as a breach of privilege of the house. The chairman or the speaker of a house may, without harm to the provision of Article 105 or as the case may be Article 194 and to any other power which he may have under this constitution, direct any intentionally violation made by any person of the rules made under paragraph 8 of 10th schedule may be handed out in the same manner as breach of privilege of the house. Thank you.